Hello, my delicious co-creators. Lilou here on the Juicy Living Tour. I'm today in beautiful San Diego, south of California, with Barnet that you already met because I've already interviewed Barnet many times, including...
I'm so glad to see you here back in California. It's been too long. Isn't it beautiful? It doesn't feel like California today. Yeah. It feels like the south of France.
And I love your way of being. There's something about you that everybody loves. And you're very well known in the Hollywood crowd, but also the whole transformational crowd, because you've brought those two worlds together, you know, bringing transformation to movies. And that is awesome. I love that. So I'm excited because I had the opportunity, of course, to interview you about the Celestine prophecy that a lot of you might have seen. I've interviewed James Redfield also. And what are some of the other movies you worked on?
Oh, I made What Dreams May Come and Homeless to Harvard. I did Jesus film. And I'm interested in two things more than anything. I'm interested in transformation and spirituality and consciousness more than anything. Mm. And also the stories that we use to share ideas about consciousness and to teach ourselves and learn from ourselves about consciousness and spirituality. And movies, well, movies do that as powerfully as anything right now. They're even like the new mythologies. We have all these old mythologies that have come up from ancient times, and we live our life inside of these things. And now in the transformational times, people are changing so much, and they're discovering their own beliefs and their own thoughts and their own choices. And they're moving off the way we've all done it collectively. And so now more than ever, the new mythologies are being shown and shared inside of films, other things as well. But we have the opportunity to make films or to make millions and reach millions and millions of people on the internet as a vehicle for your own passions and your own interests. And this is a new mythology. We're changing everything in real time. It's never been more exciting.
Yeah. And that must be quite difficult, though, in Hollywood to bring that. What, is there some resistance that you feel, or you're just deciding to take it to the new level now, to next levels? Because we want those meaningful movies, and there are some beautiful movies. I was very much touched by Avatar. That was a huge movie, and I think a lot of people all around the world. Because this there is some spiritual teachings in there.
So many, so many. Well, you're right. Hollywood is driven more and more by very, very, very big entertainments that reach as many people as possible. It's like there's no more little small restaurants. There's only big chains of restaurants. And Hollywood is only interested in being like McDonald's, as many people as you can possibly feed. The kinds of stories that you and I are interested in, and so many of your viewers and so many of the transformational leaders, we're at a transformational leadership conference right now, so many of these people, these kinds of ideas don't reach the mainstream in the same way, although our audiences are getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. And so while I'm still interested in big Hollywood movies, I'm making Illusions, Richard Bach's Illusions, with Zack Snyder, who just finished making Man of Steel, of course. And so we're making a big transformational movie. But also, there are smaller kinds of movies that are just as exciting. I'm working, you know, I've been working for a long time on a movie based on a book called Milton's Secret, which was written by Eckhart Tolle, author of The Power of Now and A New Earth, and also Robert Friedman, who was the original publisher of Conversations with God. So it's a little movie, and it's starring Peter Fonda, Easy Rider, about a young boy who lives in a very, very stressed world, and his family, his parents are having marital problems and they have financial problems, and he sees homeless people in the world. And it's a tough time to be in the world as a small person, as any person, but as a small person. And he sees, it's not a teaching kind of a film, but it's a teaching kind of a film. He sees from his grandfather a different way of being in the moment, not in the future, not worrying about the past, and he just sees it, and it opens his heart to new possibilities. So it's not the kind of movie that Hollywood says, not a lot of shooting in, but it's the kind of movie that we're so interested in, and so we're doing it outside of Hollywood, doing it with this new crowdfunding model that feels to me like consciousness itself. One of the things about consciousness is that we become our own gatekeepers. And crowdfunding allows us to do, like on public broadcasting, where they say you can support the kind of entertainment that you want to see by becoming a part of it. And that's what we're doing with Milton's Secret.
And more people are doing that way. Huh? It enables us to really tap in this co-creation.
It's so about co-creating and manifesting, and we want, so many in our community say, we want different kinds of entertainment. Well, we can be the change that we want to see, and we can all participate in it and have a voice in it, and it's fun. It's a lot of fun.
It is possible to live in a different state of consciousness, a state of consciousness that does not generate unnecessary unhappiness, suffering, and anxiety. I love watching movies, and my main life interest and my purpose in life is to bring spiritual awakening into this world. So bringing together my interest in movies and my life purpose, I became interested in movies that have the power to transform consciousness.
Milton's Secret's about an 11-year-old boy who lives in a modern life of lots of stress. His parents have a challenging marriage. They are also facing financial difficulties. He is dealing with a bully at school. There is a lot on this boy's plate. His world shifts when his grandfather comes to visit him. And without any lecturing, this boy is profoundly, profoundly changed because he witnesses in his grandfather an entirely different way to meet life. I had a meeting with Eckhart Tolle, and I explained what I had in mind, and he very generously said, well, give it a try. Go ahead and give it a try.
He told me that he had produced What Dreams May Come, which is one of my favorite movies. And so I thought, I don't need to ask him any more questions. That's enough. And that was it.
The world is going through a shift right now. I'm a conscious shift. And people are really looking towards material that can help them transition to this new world.
That's the power of transformational entertainment. As the character changes in the movie, it rubs off on the viewer.
Transformational entertainment includes movies and content that empowers individuals to make conscious decisions. I really truly believe the time is now to produce transformational entertainment. And I feel movies like Milton's Secret will act as a catalyst to inspire social change and to create a more mindful world.
We developed the script, and the feedback has always been very, very, very flattering and very generous. And at the same time, there have been requests to make changes that we felt diminished the focus, the clarity, and the purpose.
It's challenging to make this kind of film within the studio system that stays true to these values.
And then an amazing thing happened, this miraculous thing happened.
With this shift of consciousness, crowdfunding has appeared.
And suddenly we realized, well, we have this enormous audience, a transformational audience, and they have long been looking for their own entertainment.
What crowdfunding has allowed us to do is to connect with those fans at a stage where they can feel they're co-creating with us.
To have a voice, to have a sense of choice and a sense of participation, it was like the chance crossing of two miraculous developments. And we thought, maybe here is our moment.
Now, we've secured part of our financing through private investment and grants, but we're still short, which is why we need your help. We can shoot this film right away and share this wonderful story with the rest of the world.
People sometimes ask me, why aren't there more movies and there should be more movies of this kind? I do know that we're making this one, and I'm passionate about it. And I hope that people will have as many lights on or more when they leave it, and that they'll enjoy it and they'll have a great experience.
Good. I concur.
Thank you. Thank you.
some of the components or ingredients that really get people to feel this heart-to-heart connection, to receive transformation while we see a movie? Is there some behind-the-scenes little tricks or some things that, besides the music, and of course real actors that are really authentically and consciously acting, is there some other things?
There are. You know, Eckhart said, I was with him yesterday, and he said to me, what matters to him about transformation entertainment and how it's different and what we are doing, how what we're doing is a little bit different than most of what we're used to, is big stories always happen. A hero has a problem and then they take actions and they fight or they win the race or they get the girl and things outside change. And in the end, the outside world changes and we're satisfied with that. But in transformational entertainment and in Milton's Secret, it's the inside, the characters that change. This small boy, because he sees his grandfather who is a lover, who sees people, he doesn't judge people, he doesn't think he has to fix everybody, he is careful, he comes from a place where he honors his feelings. He's aware of his thoughts and his actions. He doesn't mean he has to express every single one of them. He feels deeply and he lets it go and he releases it. For a little boy to see that is so shocking for him because nowhere in his world does he ever see that kind of behavior. And when we learn in life by seeing others, and when we see that, two things happen. We say, well, I can try that as well. And we can feel what happens when we're in our bodies instead of in our minds. And also, when we see people like this, the parents of this little boy, and they're always on their devices, and they're always worried about tomorrow and thinking about what happened yesterday and worried about money. And for lots of us in the world, this is a very real issue. And when we watch a movie and we see the price of that, I look at that and I see, well, I recognize myself. I do those kinds of behaviors. And look what an impact. It removes me from being in beauty. It removes me from being able to have a present connection with people that I care about and or for my son. And it's teaching my son to live in here and not in his beautiful body and in his beautiful world. So these kinds of movies, they make a difference. It doesn't mean that everyone is going to become enlightened, but if it changes a few people and it puts on one little light, one little light, one little light, if it allows somebody to see themselves and say, I'm going to take a breath, get into my body a little bit more, I'm going to do my best not to be so worried or so obsessive or so, and maybe I'll just, I can't worry and be a lover at the same time. So maybe I'll just practice being loving. So these are kinds of stories. Every story is a love story, I always say. Everyone's a love story. Yeah. But when we show it in a way that people can recognize themselves and they can say, well, there are other kinds of behaviors I can do here. That's powerful.
Because people need to be entertained too these days. No, the rhythm has changed and people are used to really have a lot of information. And how does that translate to the kind of movie? Or you're just not following that type of
media? Well, we're both and. We're not leaving anything behind or making anything bad or wrong. We're doing that. I've made those kinds of movies and I'm good at it. And so this is still with a wonderful actor, Academy Award nominee, Golden Globe winner, Peter Fonda, and it looks like the kinds of movies you're used to seeing, and it also has other things going on it. There are other moments of such beauty that when a camera, we're sitting in front of these beautiful flowers, and when we pay attention to it and just watch how it sways in the wind, there are lessons in that for ourselves as viewers and for characters to watch a flower sway in the wind, and it has thorns, and it could prick you, but it moves, and then it comes back. There are lessons there. So we just, in this kind of movie, we're paying attention, in addition to the other fun things, we're paying attention to some kinds of poetic moments that uplift and empower, and they inspire people, and they make us more present with each other.
Yeah. So the call to action here is that if you're looking for people to support this project, right?
Well, we're hoping that people who are interested in seeing these kinds of projects and seeing this kind of movie with Peter and with Eckhart Tolle, if they would like to see this kind of thing and support it, there's an opportunity for them to participate in it. There's all sorts of rewards that we have to make it more fun, giving away scripts and autographed books and maybe a chance to be in the movie or in a set piece or maybe some private webinars. And we'll have all kinds of fun things and make a community. And we're all just exploring how we can create our transformational community into a more exciting and take it in new directions and support each other. So that's the way we can do it.
I think it's so important these days.
We have to now move, take off the training wheels of consciousness.
Yeah.
We have to walk the love now. We have to see, understand really that you and I, we're all one thing going on, and support each other in ways that are, of course, in alignment with our values and what matters to us. But we recognize fellow travelers and kindred spirits, and we support each other. And who knows what kind of a difference we can make in the world? Who knows?
We're called to come together as a collective and really make the difference. And we're on the same soul mission.
Together, one piece. And now it's being revealed that they're all connected. Yeah. There's one thing here. This is a family that's growing and growing and growing and growing. We're creating a sense of community. We're creating energies that are causal. We're creating frequencies of love that are causal. Mm. We will see ourselves more reflected in the world, where attention goes, energy follows. So more and more we see these incredible synchronicities. I find you down here.
Yeah.
And
we just have to follow the flow.
We follow the flow.
Yeah.
We
follow our intuition. This feels good to be speaking with you. I'm so excited. Thank you so much for showing up. And I really look forward to spending more time with you, Barnett.
I love you so much.
Thank you.
This is an old relationship, so we go back for a few years, and it's always such a miracle. It's always so much fun to be with you and to see you.
Thank you. And to all delicious co-creators out there, I send you big, big kisses and wish you an amazing, amazing day today. And whatever you could pick up, whatever little bit of inspiration or action that you can take in your life, please do it, because it's a little step after another and another that then creates this beautiful picture and the world changes.
It changes like this, before we know it.
Thank you for being the change. Big, big kiss.